Hello everybody, this is Luke at Al's TV and we are here today with BioPhil at the Southern Hemp Expo. And I was just truly amazed to come and stop by this booth, and so I couldn't resist but coming over to ask a couple more questions. So first of all, could you please introduce yourself and talk to us a little bit about what we see here on the table, and I suppose just what it's taken to get to this point now, from not being farm bill compliant to now we have a fully thriving industrial hemp industry that's this side of things I had never even seen before.
My name's Heidi Kuster. I'm with Tuscarora Mills. We make natural fiber fabrics. And on this table is just an illustration of the process of what it takes to go from the plant in the field to a yarn, which is what we use to make fabric. So over here is fiber that's been decorticated.
Now, when we say fiber, for just somebody who maybe has little to no idea of, you know, what fiber is, can you maybe bring us back to, how, before we even get to the fiber, can you explain, like, what is fiber, and how do we get that from this plant that we always think more of, like, smoking?
Right. So what you smoke is the flower part.
Okay.
The fiber actually comes from the stalk, and that's technically called a bast fiber.
Okay.
Flax is also a bast fiber, and it comes from the exterior of the stalk. Inside is the herd, and that's also a useful material, especially for building. But the strands on the outside of the stalk is the fiber that we would use to make fabric.
Okay, gotcha. So that obviously has a hell of a lot of use cases, right? And so this is just one of thousands.
A lot of uses, yes. There's a lot of uses. But it's, you know, what type of plant you grow really depends on the end use. You know, so if you want to grow for seed, that's probably a different plant than what you would grow for fiber.
Okay, great. And so you utilize this product in order to turn it into a fabric that you can then use. Can you explain to us how this is sort of step one over here, where the stalks are smashed, they're smashed together into different tiers, basically, is it? There's a herd, fiber.
Right.
What else is there?
Well, you basically want to separate the fiber from the herd.
Okay,
and then once you have that separated, the herd can be used for other applications, especially hempcrete and insulation and things like that. The fiber then has to be further processed to remove as much of the herd as you possibly can. Then the next process would be to degum the fiber. So the plant has lignum, which holds all those strands together. Mm-hmm. It's a very sticky substance, which you want to remove. So that's like this process right here.
And Alex, if you can just show that over here. So we've got, so this is sort of step one, and this is decorticated. And as you can see, this is sort of still pieces of the herd.
Yep.
But as you post-process, you begin to get to pieces with no herd at all in it, and then yep. So walk us down this list here and explain to us what we got.
This is then degummed and whitened.
Okay, gotcha.
And so this fiber has been chopped up into small pieces so that it can be combined with cotton and spun here in the United States. In Europe, they can process the longer fiber, so it would go from a fibrous mess like this into a sliver, which is like a roving or a long rope, which then gets spun into a yarn with a wet spinning process. So this is a wet spinning yarn with a long fiber. This right here is a 50-50 cotton and hemp, cottonized hemp.
Incredible. And then if you can take us over to these wonderful clothes here. Now, if you can explain to us these beautiful garments here, just right off the bat, the best texture, how would you describe this texture?
It's a heavyweight twill. It was made on a denim loom. And this has the blend of hemp and cotton. So it's a heavier, sort of a durable fabric. On this particular fabric, we used 100% cotton or 100% hemp yarn on the warp, and we filled with the blended hemp and cotton, the cottonized hemp and cotton. So it ends up being 70% hemp, 30% cotton.
Right.
Then this one is 100% hemp.
100% hemp. Okay. So is the this definitely feels it would be a little firmer than denim, I would say almost. It's harder than denim.
Yeah, it's more durable than denim. I mean, denim is a pretty durable fabric because it is a twill weave. Any twill is stronger than a plain weave, but this, because of the fiber that it's made with, is extremely durable. I mean, it will last for years and years. Because, hemp is a very strong fabric.
Now, for those people who maybe say, oh, that's too firm, it's too hard, I don't want to wear that, what do you have to say to those people?
Wash it a few times.
Wash your clothes, everybody. Make sure to wash your clothes. But then there's ones here which have sort of it's a blend, right? The outside is more harder or firmer, and then the inside has got that cotton.
Yes, yeah. This is a combination of just using the different fibers on the warp and the weft to achieve different effects. So this one is a little bit softer at the get-go, that's because it has a lot of organic cotton, which is super soft.
Yes.
But then you also have the hemp on for the fill, which gives it a lot of durability. Right. So it's like the best of both worlds here. And then we also do blends with like a Supima cotton. It just depends on...
Supima cotton, talk to us. I've never heard of Supima cotton before. Maybe I'm just not in the fabric game, but talk to me a little bit about Supima cotton, please.
Supima cotton is a longer staple fiber. So cotton is a staple fiber. Normally it's a little bit shorter, but if you've heard of like Egyptian cotton and Pima cotton, that is the same family as Supima, only Supima is branded like to be specifically grown in the U.S.
Okay, great. And so can you talk to, I suppose we're a little bit busy on this side, but I'd love us to maybe be passed off and talk to somebody else who can show us, this is just one aspect of this business, right, which is the fabrics.
Yeah.
But there's like a whole other, just different tiers that somebody else is gonna be able to show us, is that right?
Yeah, there's bags of herd.
Yep.
They make a comfy product with, and they also use for insulation. So that's one aspect. It's like that's what this stuff that we would just get rid of, you know, the textile industry.
Sure.
And then there's the degumming of the fiber right there. That's what Naden does there.
Okay, great. Okay, so just picking up where we left off, we're now speaking with Naden, and Naden is responsible for more of the post-processing. So once we decorticate, can you explain to us, we've got our herd, and then we also have our fiber.
Yep.
But some of that herd and fiber is still stuck together, right?
Right. So the primary mission of the decortication is to remove as much of the herd as possible from the fiber.
Yep.
What we're focused on specifically at Try and Finishing is preparing fiber for textile and apparel use downstream. So certainly getting as much herd out of it as possible is the objective. Now, the process, as you know, from a cotton standpoint, you have the cotton gin. You grow it, you gin, and then you go into the textile process.
Yep.
The two-step process is for the tech for hemp processing. So there's the decortication process, which is the mechanical, kind of you feed the stalks in, it's basically breaking apart the herd from the fiber, on the bast fiber on the outside. But once you do that, you have, in order to go into the textile chain in the U.S. or internationally, you have to have a cleaner fiber.
Okay.
So what we do is we do what's called a degumming or some people call it cottonization, some people call it wet processing.
So we do degumming actually in the extraction space as well.
Okay.
I wonder, is it the, it's the same thing, right? We're trying to get rid of those sticky gums.
I mean, the gist of it is you're basically, we use large vats, and what you're basically doing is you're bringing it up to a temperature and with some steam and pressure, and basically what that does is that helps break apart the fibers.
Okay, so it's naturally not going to fit in with the water, right? So it's going to rise to the top. Is that what it is?
Well, it's actually what you're trying to do. If you look, like, for example, on some of this, you can see some of the fibers are all kind of ribboned and banded together.
Yes.
So what we're trying to do is this. So this is what we would get in for a raw material standpoint, and then once we process it, it really breaks apart the fibers and gets much finer fiber
really
coming out of it.
Oh, that's really incredible. This is actually really soft. So Alex, if you can show down here, so this here is more like a harsh is maybe too much of a word, but it's coarse, right? Whereas this here is now getting down to that soft, like, oh, I can imagine this possibly on a sweatshirt.
Right, exactly.
This is like, this belongs in an animal bed.
Yeah, you're not gonna blend that with a cotton or any other fiber and have a comfortable
that's
t-shirt,
not be
right?
Comfortable on the skin.
but this is, now we're getting to the point where you can blend it in with cotton. What we've seen a lot is sort of a 70-30 cotton hemp blend.
Okay.
Is worked well, at least from the yarn manufacturing. So that's what we're trying. Our customer is the yarn manufacturer in the traditional textile chain.
Okay, and for those who are maybe. Have no idea about hemp versus cotton. Why would somebody choose to use, let's say, hemp yarn versus cotton yarn?
Sure. So I mean, I think from a characteristic standpoint, there's a lot of positives from hemp. You know, besides just the, call it the sustainability story of the water usage and the pesticides that cotton uses versus, say, what hemp uses. So you know, that sort of sustainability is a big aspect of it. Other aspect, the actual fiber itself, though, has the strength of the fiber is a stronger fiber than cotton, and it also has some other characteristics like UV resistance that is better than cotton's. So you know, there are actually some true characteristics of the fiber itself that makes it a better fiber than cotton.
What are some of the hurdles that that you're seeing from, often some people say, like, hey, you know, like, hemp's going to just, like, you know, take over the world. We're going to switch everything over to hemp. Obviously, that may be right at one point in time. But what is it right now? Is it that you see from an industry perspective of whether it's, hey, we can't supply enough of it or we can't grow enough of it? Is there any hurdles that are currently you're having?
Sure. No, great question. I mean, there's a ton of hurdles right now, right? I mean, because you're talking about a supply chain from farmer up until the textile yarn spinning for hemp that just doesn't exist right now. And since it's a different process than, you know, you look at a synthetic fiber like a nylon or polyester that's extruded, that's a whole nother ballgame.
Sure.
Cotton has its own way of cotton ginning. That's their own process. This hemp process is not, there's just not that supply chain. So from my standpoint, kind of being the last step in the process, there's not enough, from my perspective, decortication capacity today. But even taking a step further back from a farming standpoint, everyone's been growing over the last couple of years. Since they started growing, the focus has been on CBD and that.
If I'm right here, this looks like an industrial plant.
Yes.
So,
yeah,
okay.
It just showed up there. How about that?
So let's have a little walk over here and see this industrial plant, because it does look very different. I think everybody is typically used to, you know, big buds.
Yep, the bushy, small, yep.
Yeah, and so this is obviously very different, big, long stalks. Let's talk a little bit about the main differences, I suppose, between industrial hemp and your smokable hemp.
And smokable, sure. So the stalks are, you know, that's the obvious difference there. What we're trying to do from the growth standpoint is, and this is probably about, from the plant, I mean, maybe 8 feet. So we're looking it obviously looks more like a bamboo shoot than it does a traditional plant.
Yeah.
So, but the longer the stalks, the better quality fiber that we're going to get out of it. So, and actually from a, you can see there's some of these plants you've seen around here, they're, you know, much thicker.
Yep.
This is about ideal right here. I mean, called a number two pencil. It's about that sort of width is what we found.
Okay, so too big of a branch is actually going to be a hindrance to the decortication process, is it?
Right, well, there's a couple things. So, and if they're not planted close enough together, you're going to get a lot more branching out, and then you'll have, you know, you'll see where branches came out here.
Yep.
That's, you know, you the closer you plant together, the more you're going to get more of the true stalks.
Yeah, if you have like a 6-inch is more used to for doing the growing rather than like much further apart if you're growing buds. Obviously, from what you're saying is you want it higher up, more densely together than bushy.
Right. So see, and so I'm not a farmer by any stretch. I handle a certain, but from what I've learned over the last year, I mean, a much closer growth, whether even maybe even closer than 6 inches, is what's going to promote the high. The, you know, this type of growth versus the smaller bushier ones.
Okay, and so as an industrial farmer, I know you're not an industrial farmer, sorry, but in terms of this business, I mean, so there's the herd, then there's also the seed, as well as the fiber, all in one. A farmer could really grow a tri-crop, is it?
Right.
Is that when you take the oil as well?
Right, well, yeah, I would say the primary ones for this is going to be the fiber and it's going to be the herd for, you know, for the building products and more of industrial applications. So, I'm not too attuned as far as the, you know, the seed and the oil and all that from this particular type of plant.
Okay, great. Well, just an absolute pleasure. Do you want to just share quickly with our YouTubers where can we find more about your business and how can they become more educated on it?
Sure, sure. So we have a textile plant in Tryon, North Carolina called Tryon Finishing. So you can go to tryonfinishing.com and see a little bit about what we do. We do not just hemp, but we do a lot of, you know, fabric printing and sort more traditional textiles as well. So.
Excellent.
Yeah, appreciate
Excellent.
It.
Okay, well, look, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate
yeah,
it.
Yeah, thanks
All
so
right,
much.
Bye-bye.
Appreciate it.
Cheers.
You bet.